When I stand on the mountain and I say, do it, it gets done. If it don't get done, then I'll move on it. And that's the last thing in the world you want me to do.
So today we're going to talk about extra board, kind of in depth, just a little bit. It's very straightforward once you get into it, and you'll see what I mean once you start doing it. Which I've made a couple of videos about it before, but I don't think they, I don't know how they fared. I don't know how many of you guys have actually seen that and got a job here and weren't sure exactly how it went. But obviously I was on the extra board when I started this channel, and I just thought I would touch on it again because it was requested. So here we go. You're going to be given a day to start, and you're going to start on that day every week. If it's Wednesday, it's Wednesday. If it's Friday, it's Friday. If it's Monday, it's Monday. Whatever day they give you, that's the day you're going to start. And then while you're at home, you're going to call your terminal. This is who I am. I'm coming off a reset. Y'all got me ready. Y'all have any freight that I can go ahead and move out with? Do I need to wait? Whatever. If they say, hey, I don't have you lined up yet, but I'll call Central, see if they'll line you up. And if that's the case, wait about 15 minutes after you hang up the phone, and then check your driver portal, which is a mobile website you can check. I don't know why it's not an app yet, but it's a mobile website. And it gives you information like, hey, this is where you're going. These are your trailers. Here's the manifest numbers. Here's the lodging at that terminal if you need it. Here's the final mile directions to that terminal. And here is the address to that terminal. Here's the gate code to that terminal. All that information's right there on that portal, which is pretty good information to have. If you have all that on there, go ahead and head in. Obviously, sometimes it's better to call the terminal back and say, hey, are these trailers there? Are they ready to go? Because sometimes they'll have you lined up on something like that, and one of those trailers could be en route to that terminal, but it's still 2 hours away, and you don't want to show up too early like that. But if you call them, another response you may get is, we don't have anything ready yet. We're still trying to get our schedules out. And what that means is all the scheduled line haul guys, all the guys with the dedicated routes that are usually home daily, they're trying to load all their freight so they can get all those guys out so they can get to, you know, where they need to be on time and everything. So they're going to get that stuff ready first. And then they're going to work on getting the extra board driver some freight. And sometimes they don't even have extra freight. So you'll probably end up taking empties out of a small terminal. Done that several times, especially at my own terminal. If you call the terminal and the terminal is closed, just call Central directly. Tell them who you are. Tell them you're coming off a reset. You're trying to get out of the house. And they'll go ahead and line you up. So once they do all that, go ahead and leave the house. Go to the terminal. Transfer all the stuff that you take with you out of your personal vehicle and into the truck that you take. Go ahead and get the paperwork that you're looking for if the terminal's closed, or go ahead and go inside or whatever you got to do. But once you get everything hooked up, you call Central back if that's who you got to deal with, or you go back in and talk to a dispatcher. They're going to want your tractor number and dolly number. They can dispatch you out of there. And all of this is going to come second nature to you. When you start doing it more and more and more, you'll just know what you got to do, what they're going to want from you, and what you need from them. It's just going to go like clockwork. Starting out, it might take you a little time to hook a set. I don't know how quick you are at doing it. Some guys, when they first start, it takes 45 minutes to an hour. It doesn't take that long. You know, once you do it all the time, every day, 15 minutes or less typically is what it takes. The large terminals takes a while to find these trailers. Now, they do have a fleet locator app now. Now, not all of the trailers are on there currently, but they, you know, they're all supposed to be on there by the end of the year. All I can say is it works about 95% of the time. I can just open that trailer locator app at a large terminal. Like, I go to Memphis every night. I use it every day. That way, I'm not spending 15 to 20 minutes looking for two trailers. When I can just get this app out, it'll tell me exactly where the trailer is located on the yard. And so you start doing the extra board, you'll get into all of that, you'll figure it out how to use it. I mean, it's very simple, it's very straightforward. And that's basically the steps you're going to take every day. Now, when you get to your first terminal, after you left home, you're going to take that freight, whatever they gave you, to the first terminal. And I say first, it might be the only terminal you go to. It might be 600 miles away. Great, you got an awesome run right out of the gate. But for me, a small terminal like I'm at, they typically send me to a big terminal to get more freight going a longer distance. If that's the case, when you get to that other terminal, they're going to ask you how much time you have left. They want to know how much drive time you have left. So just tell them, hey, it took me 3 hours to get here. Okay, what's on my 11 hour right now? Oh, okay, I still got, you know, 8 hours left. And they'll be like, great, here's some freight, you know. Go out there, hook it up, come back in, give them your dolly and your tractor. They'll dispatch you and you're off. In my case, I've done this a few times where I left Little Rock, went to Memphis. They gave me freight going to Knoxville, Tennessee. You go to Knoxville, I'm out of time. I mean, I'm not out of time. I got some time left on my 11-hour drive clock. And you can tell them, hey, yeah, I've got enough time. I've got, you know, 2 hours left, or I got an hour and a half left. Whatever you got left, because I can't remember how far it is. They're going to tell you, more than likely, go ahead and shut down. Okay. So you'll walk back out to your truck, do a post-trip inspection, and go off-duty PC, which is personal conveyance, and that's what you'll use to get from that terminal, last terminal of the day, to the hotel. Like I said earlier about the driver portal, that has lodging information in there as well as a CLC app. Now, how do they pay for your hotels? Well, they give you a corporate lodging card, which is like a company credit card, sort of, and it just pays for hotels. So when you get to the hotel, they're going to want your CLC card along with your driver's license. And that's how they check you into the hotel. And when you get ready to leave the hotel, just come back down to the reception and give them your room keys. And they might want to know the room number. And you just go from there. So it's a fairly simple process, pretty straightforward. The only thing extra that you have to do that I didn't say already is when you hook a set or break a set, you'll have to log that in two places. The first place is your ELD. You just go to messages, go to your inbox, and go down to create a form. And it'll be probably third or fourth from the top. It'll say something like East Drop Hook. If you're out west, it probably says West Drop Hook. I'm not sure. But over here where we are, it'll say East Drop Hook. And you'll click on that. And then a template will open. And you'll have to fill out your driver number, the terminal ID number for the terminal you're at, where you did the dropping and hooking at, and which is a 3-digit number. Then you have to put in your manifest if it's a loaded trailer. You have to put in your trailer number, and it'll ask you if it's empty or not. You would say no, and then it'll open up another tab. That's where you put in your manifest number. And that's pretty much it. And you send that off to payroll. Your recipient for that email should be payroll at your terminal. The second place you'll have to write that down is on your trip sheet. We have a weekly trip sheet. For every load that you run, you have to fill out a line on the trip sheet, which is not, it doesn't take long. Like I said, once you start doing this all the time, it'll be second nature. You'll be like, okay, I'm just going to fill it out real quick. You'll put the terminal ID number, which is that 3-digit number, at the origin, where you currently are, and then the 3-digit ID number for the destination, where you're currently going. You'll have to write down your tractor number, the trailer number, the manifest number for that trailer, and then write down if you hooked it or dropped it. And if you didn't make the set or break the set, you don't write anything. Thanks for watching the video. I'll talk to y'all later.
Every one of you out there has tried to kill me for the last 25 years, and I'm still here. Ha, ha, ha. Now what?